It's my distinct privilege to introduce His Excellency, the Ambassador of Bangladesh, Mr. Mohammad Ziauddin. He's the eldest child of the late Professor Dr. Mohammad Ziauddin and Mr. Shantan Nahara Ziauddin. He went to St. Gregory's High School, completed Intermediate Arts from Notre Dame College, obtained B honors and MA in English Literature from Dhaka University. Ambassador Ziauddin joined the BCS Foreign Service with seniority from July 1974. He served as Third and Second Secretary in Bangladesh High Commission in London, First Secretary in Bangladesh High Commission in Nairobi, Counselor and Deputy Permanent Representative at the Permanent Mission of Bangladesh to the United Nations in New York. Prior to joining as Bangladesh Ambassador to Italy, he was Director General in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Chief of Portfolio of the Government of Bangladesh. Ambassador Ziauddin joined as Ambassador to Italy on 15 May 2000 and assumed concurrent charge as Ambassador to the Republic of Albania and the Republic of Bosnia and Herzegovina. He was also the permanent representative of Bangladesh to FAO, WFP, and IFAE. Ambassador Mohammad Ziauddin obtained diploma in commercial policy in 1977 at GAP, Geneva, completed foreign service training in 1980 in Canberra, and the United States Congressional Fellowship in 1989 and 90 under the American Political Science Association in Washington, D.C. Prior to joining as Bangladesh Ambassador to the USA, he held the post of Ambassador at Large to the Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina with the rank and status of State Minister to the Government of Bangladesh. Ambassador Mohammad Ziauddin is married to Yasmin Ziauddin. They have a son and daughter. And it's my distinct privilege today to welcome Ambassador Ziauddin to the podium and give us some inspirational words.
Has given to me cannot match the colorful gathering which is which I see in front of me. It is really a flash of area of colors in front of me, which I see. And what a splendor is in me. Just as my predecessor, Mr. Sharif, I wish to speak from my heart, and therefore I've taken out this script which I had prepared for this occasion. Mr. Chairperson, members of the Bangladesh Association of Houston, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and good evening to you all. It is a great pleasure for me to be with you today at this multicultural gala in the magnificent city of Houston. I warmly congratulate the Bangladesh Association of Houston for organizing this fantastic event and thank them for inviting me here to join in the celebration. I also warmly felicitate the association and its associates for another year of laudable success. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud that the Bangladesh Association of Houston and its associates since establishment in 1978 have been holding this annual event. It has been revealing and contributing Bangladesh's rich cultural heritage among all other fellow citizens and entrenching further the already rich socio-cultural fabric of this marvelous city. Through its 37 years of existence, the non-profit Bangladesh Association of Houston have also been deeply involved in community development activities, including supporting the Mayor's International and Development Council by providing free medical services, organizing cultural events, involving diverse cultural groups, and promoting education. It has also been playing an important role as a liaison between the Bangladesh diaspora and the local and the federal leaders, as well as various state and federal agencies. I encourage them to continue engaging more deeply into the mainstream of US politics and community development affairs in the coming days. Ladies and gentlemen, today we live in a globalized world. With the intensification of the social process of globalization, we are interconnecting and integrating at an unthinkable pace. In this free and unrestrained era of information and communications, Bangladesh has a huge comparative advantage to capitalize on. Notably, we have one of the largest and perhaps one of the most committed diaspora around the world, while integrating with the cultural values of the host countries. Our people remain equally faithful to the homes of their ancestors. The resident Bangladeshis, by their nature and character, wants to give something to their motherland. They are true flag bearers of Bangladesh in their countries of residence. Their extraordinary commitment needs to be tapped by an ICE network linking them and their associates in Bangladesh. Our diaspora members can easily use ICT for transferring knowledge and technical know-how to Bangladesh. They can determine their areas of contribution or the optimum utilization of their talents, select their working hours, and contribute to Bangladesh's socio-economic development. Indeed, the technological breakthroughs of our time has opened up vast horizons for the resident and non-resident Bangladeshi to connect with and join in the extraordinary work in Bangladesh in areas that are diverse, including education, health, climate change, fight against poverty, and the menace of terrorism. The government of Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina considers its expatriate community as an inseparable part of Bangladesh. She is highly appreciative of their role in our socio-economic development and never forgets to praise them for their contributions to our political, economic, cultural, and other spheres of social life. These appreciations arise from a deeply entrenched belief that Bangladesh and its diaspora have strong and uninterrupted connections between themselves. Bangladesh is proud that its diaspora has been successful in assimilating with the mainstream US culture and society. Today we have amongst our second generation Bangladeshis highly qualified professionals, lawyers, accountants, bankers, and politicians. Our new generation diaspora members are becoming increasingly visible in important places of US socio-political arena, including professional engagement, business, politics, cultural activities, and community development programs. The existence of a thriving Bangladeshi American community adds greatly to the strength of our bilateral relations. The Bangladesh diaspora in the USA has been playing a praiseworthy role in bridging cultural, social, and development gaps between our two countries. They are helping the socio-economic growth of Bangladesh by their valuable references to their country of origin. They have also created a wider platform of sharing knowledge, ideas, values, and culture between the peoples of our two friendly countries. These are good work that our diaspora must continue by increasing their level of engagement for the betterment of the US-Bangladesh relationship. Ladies and gentlemen, before I conclude, I once again thank the Bangladesh Association of Houston for their tireless efforts in making this event so successful. I request all present here to continue their hard work with us in building Sonar Bangla as enriched. vision by the father of our nation, Gala Wanda Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. I also wish that all of us here and elsewhere in the USA work as parents and teachers in instilling our children with the knowledge of a bigger picture than what they see. By connecting them to their cultures, by teaching them their mother language, and so on. So that they know their true identity and be proud of their origin. Our duty should be to make our children know the need to have kinship with their ancestral home. I also urge upon you all to remember the important role that you can play in changing the lives of millions in Bangladesh. I'm confident that through the intensification of your appeal with your country, you shall not only benefit yourselves and the societies in which you live in, but also benefit your beloved home of origin, Bangladesh. With that, these few remarks, these few words, I wish the multicultural gala meeting 2015 organized by the Bangladesh Association of Houston a grand success. I thank you all. Long live Bangladesh-US friendship.